Hey everybody, and welcome once again to another edition of OVW Mania here on Triple Threat Talk. I am Brian Cannon, and if you watched last week, you would have seen me twice. I was actually with both the Doctor and Big V following OVW, which I'm going to be going over in just a moment. So they actually know a little bit about last week's episode, because apparently I can watch their whole hour and 45 minute videos, but they don't watch my little 8 minute videos that I send in as part of the show. So not that I'm bitter or anything, but I was on last week right after the OVW taping. I had a little segment with the Doctor talking about PEDs and the whole biogenesis thing going on in baseball, and that was a lot of fun to do. But I'm going to be going over the episode we watched that night. It was number 727 for OVW. It was taped last Wednesday, which was July 24th. Of course, uploaded the next day on blip.tv and ovwrestling.com. And then on Ion TV, WBNA 21, Saturday the 27th. The show started off with Jay Bradley coming to the ring to talk about his upcoming match with Jamin Oliventia, talking about the whole contract debacle from the week before with Joseph Park and all that stuff. And they end up both saying they've got stipulations in the contract. And Jace got the stipulation that he can pick anybody as Jamin's opponent for that night. And as he's telling him this, Marcus Anthony comes out and attacks Jamin Oliventia from behind. And Jay tells Jamin that he just met his opponent for tonight's main event. The next match was kind of a surprise. It was a number one contenders match. The VIP club, at least in this match, was Roberto De Luna and Jay Best. They defeated the really, really new Rockers, Ryan Howe, Rockstar Spud. It was an upset win, I would say, even though it was because VIP threw champagne or something in the eyes of Ryan Howe as he rolled up Jay Best, and Jay Best ended up getting the roll up on Howe after that happened. And we found out later in the night on one of the backstage videos that any two members of the VIP club can fight for the tag team titles. So come SNS, it could be VIP and Roberto. It could be Roberto and Jay Best, who actually won the match. It could be Jay Best and VIP. It could be any combination, as it sounds like they're going to be using the Freebird rule for the match coming up Saturday against Muhammad Ali Vaez and Michael Hayes. More on that later. The Marauders continued to destroy. They actually had a dark match earlier in the night where they defeated Eddie Diamond and Lambda Lambda Lambda. They actually had a partner for him, Mr. Marvelous, but he walked away and said, "Nah, I ain't getting involved in this." But during the main show, it was Joe Coleman in singles action. He beat the illusionist Damian Adams. Apparently, Damian had been in OVW before, back around, I think, like 2008, and this was his first time back in a couple years. So he actually had a decent showing, but Joe Coleman, of course, the Marauders getting taking care of business right now. The Femme Fatales were out next. It started off with the A-listers, Taylor Hendricks and Envy. Taylor was talking about wanting to become a four-time women's champion. The women's champion herself, Trina, then came out and said, "Hey, are you challenging me?" She goes, "Because I'll accept any challenge." And then the rest of the Femme Fatales came out one by one. Heidi Lovelace came out and said that she beat Taylor with the kiss of death. Jessie Bell came out and said that she should get a shot because she never got a rematch after she lost the title to Epiphany a couple SNSs ago. Nikki St. John came out and said that she deserves a shot. She said she knows what Taylor's all about and knows what Heidi's after. The Blossoms come out and both say that they should get a title shot, and then they start arguing with each other. Lala comes out and says she deserves a shot, and then they all start fighting, and as they're fighting, Lady Tapa's music hits, and she comes out and basically her and Trina clear the ring, where they're the last two in the ring, and Trina turns around into a big boot from Lady Tapa, and Lady Tapa says she's here to dominate and that the ring is her island. So it looks like we could have a women's title match coming up at SNS between them as well. The TV title on the line once again between Dylan Bostic and Rudy Switchblade. It didn't end well the week before for Rudy. Same thing happened here. Dylan Bostic got the win this time by count out. Tony Gunn came out in between entrances and said that he was looking for Randy Royal, and said that he couldn't find him anywhere, and he was going to sit at ringside until Royal came out, which he ended up sitting over by the announce table with Gilbert Corsi and Dean Hill with his back turned to one of the entrances, and Randy Royal came out halfway through the match and attacked Tony Gunn from behind with a steel chair. Then Rudy Switchblade had Dylan Bostic in the Boston Crab. Dylan was actually tapping, but the referee was concerned with what was going on outside between Randy Royal and Tony Gunn. So Rudy went after Randy Royal, and that caused the count-out win for Dylan Bostic. Jesse Godders came out in the pink bunny suit that he has to keep on until he can get a victory. He told Dean Hill to pick anybody. He just wants to get a win so he can get out of the suit. So Dean leaves for a moment, comes back with the Welsh Colossus, Rob Terry, and Big Rob pretty much destroys Jesse, and Jesse is still stuck in the bunny suit. Jesse was not happy, especially with the fans after the match, because a lot of fans had carrots, Easter baskets. I had a sign that said the inner Jesse bunny just keeps losing and losing and losing. And then the main event was, of course, Jamin Olivencia and Marcus Anthony. Jamin gets the win after reversing the Gamma Punch into a standing O. And then he tells Jay, who tried to interfere during the match, Marcus Anthony actually hit Jay Bradley off the apron for trying to get involved. But Jamin tells Jay that one of the stipulations in the contract is that he gets to pick an opponent for Jay Bradley before SNS, and that next week on the show, he will be going one-on-one with Rob Terry. For more details on all the matches, as well as the other dark match results, and of course my other news and top 20s and all that stuff, don't forget to go to ovwmania.blogspot.com. You can find all kinds of cool stuff there. I'm going to take a quick break, and when we come back, I'm going to talk a little bit about Saturday Night Special that's coming up this Saturday, and I will be talking about the next OVW episode, which will be 728. And Saturday Night Special on next week's episode, but I'll kind of give you a rundown of what you can expect on SNS right after this. Okay, so as I said, next week we'll be going over next week's episode of OVW, which is 728, the last one before Saturday Night Special on August 3rd. I'll be talking about both those events on next week's Triple Threat Talk. But for Saturday Night Special, don't forget, you can go there Saturday night, August 3rd, 7:30 p.m. to the Davis Arena, 4400 Shepherdsville Road. If you can get your tickets in advance, they're only $10. They're $12 if you wait till you get to the door that night. But you can expect to see the following. Muhammad Ali Vaez and Michael Hayes will be putting the Southern Tag Team titles on the line against the VIP Club. Which two members will it be? Will it be VIP and Birdo? Will it be VIP and Jay Best? Or will it be Jay Best and Roberto? Nobody knows until we get there that night. It'll be the Boomstick versus the Standing O, as the challenger, Jay Bradley, hopes to take away the OVW heavyweight title from the current champion, Jamin Olivencia. It's not confirmed, but I would say it's probably going to happen. We might know for sure on the next OVW TV, but I would say Trina will more than likely be putting the OVW Women's Championship on the line against Lady Tapa. And then some other matches that could possibly happen, other things that you might see Jesse Godders, if he's there Saturday night, he could be in action to try to get out of the bunny suit still. With all the femme fatales currently in OVW, as hot as that division has gotten right now, there could be another women's match on the card. I'm sure the Marauders will be in action in some shape or form. And the TV title will probably be on the line with Dylan Bostic involved. possibly some situation, some scenario with Rudy Switchblade and Randy Royal. It's not confirmed yet, but I would say there's a good chance of that happening as well. So don't forget, I'll be talking about that next week. A couple other little tidbits before I let you go. Don't forget to follow my good friend referee Chris Sharp at Ref Chris Sharp on Twitter. This week he put out a new podcast with OVW alumni, former WWE superstar of the Spirit Squad. He was a tag team champion. We're talking about Mike Mondo. He was the special guest this week. It was a real good listen. So make sure you go check that out. And if you can't make any of the OVW live events and you're interested in the results for those, most of the time Sharpie puts them up following the live events on his Twitter feed. So like I said, go follow him there and check out all the cool stuff that he puts out. And then finally, I just found out about this today on Facebook, as I'm sure a lot of other people did too. This is the last week for at least a while, because of his job, which is understandable. But Terry Bodie will be at the next OVW TV and Saturday Night Special on August 3rd, but this is his last week with his job. He's just not got enough time to do both. So he'll be stepping away from ring announcing in OVW for a while. And Terry, thank you very much for all that you've done for both OVW Mania, for Triple Threat Talk, and for all the wrestling fans at the Davis Arena each and every week. You're a great person, great fan advocate. We're gonna miss seeing you every week, but you know, we understand why you have to step away. So you go do your thing, and hopefully, like you always tell everybody else, soon in the future, we will see you at the shows once again. That's all we've got for this week. So I guess we're just going to kick it back to the studio with Big B, the Doctor, and Postmaster Jones. Have a good week.